friends, and welcome to Pajama Prayers. It's really good to have you with me tonight. And you are going to be so happy that you are watching, because tonight we have something special on our show. We usually begin our show with hidden pictures, but tonight we have a surprise video for you. Watch. And now it's time for... Is that for real? Did you know Italy is a peninsula in the south of Europe? That means it's almost completely surrounded by the Mediterranean Sea. Italy is easy to recognize on any world map because the country is shaped like a high-heeled boot. It looks like the boot is kicking a ball, which is the island of Sicily. Don't you think? The flag of Italy is a tricolor flag composed of three vertical bands, green, white, and red. Some say they represent faith, hope, and charity. The capital city of Italy is Rome. It is one of the oldest cities in the world. Some of the most beautiful, oldest monuments in the world are found in Rome. One of these is the Colosseum, an important theater where emperors organized performances and athletic competitions. Here, gladiators fought each other, as well as tigers and lions. Rome is also the capital of the Catholic religion. The Pope is the leader, and his headquarters are in Rome. Every Sunday, he speaks to the people in St. Peter's Square. Hallelujah. Now, here's a fascinating fact. The world's most active volcano, Mount Vesuvius, is located in Italy. The eruption in AD 79 buried the city of Pompeii in ash, and because the city was buried so quickly by volcanic ash, the site was well preserved, and it was rediscovered about 300 years ago. Take a look at this. The Italian Post uses these weird and wonderful vehicles to deliver people's mail. These cute little quadricycles are completely electric. This may come as a surprise. Pinocchio was first published in an Italian newspaper. And a few more surprising facts. Gelato is taken so seriously in Italy that there is a whole university dedicated to the study and instruction of gelato making. Also, it is illegal to die in one town in South Italy. The law has been in place since 2012. The reason? The cemetery's full. Did you know that Italians believe the number 17 is bad luck? That's why some buildings in Italy don't have a 17th floor. This superstition comes from the Roman numeral 17. That's because these letters are an anagram of Roman numeral 17 with a lowercase m, which is Latin, meaning I have lived, or my life is over. And take a look here at some of the most amazing Italian inventions. There's jeans, the helicopter, a calculator, Nutella, which we're all thankful for, a parachute, and the violin. What is the most popular sport played in Italy, you ask? Soccer. Many children also play a soccer board game. Did you know the Italian pasta is renowned worldwide and is eaten at least once a day? There are more than 200 different shapes. Pizza is surely one of the country's most famous exports, and in Italy, it is usually baked in a wood-fired oven. Italian pizza is very thin, but it's loaded with fresh vegetables or thinly sliced ham, salami, artichokes, or olives. You'll love this. Italy is famous for sports cars. For example, the Ferrari FF sells for over $300,000. Now that's a chunk of change for sure. Here's an interesting fact. 1/3 of all European animal species can be found in Italy, and 1/2 of the plant species that grow in Europe. In the Alps, you will very likely see the marmots, which make a very high-pitched calling sound. And if you're very lucky, you might even spot a lynx, a wild cat with little hair tufts on its ears. Finally, and this is my favorite, the Italian alphabet consists of only 21 letters. The letters J, K, W, X, and Y do not exist, except for what they call lean words. That means words that originate in another language. Now that's something that will make you wonder, is that for real?
Was I right? Aren't you glad you were watching? I thought that was great information, and honestly, some of it did have me saying, is that for real? I'm glad you enjoyed it. We're going to move on to our story tonight. The name of our story is Pip the Penguin, and you're going to like this too.
Pip the Little Penguin. Pip is black and Pip is white. Just a regular penguin, dark and light. But Pip does not like black and white. He feels so dull. He wants to be bright. Then one day, Pip looked up at a light-filled sky. He looked at his dad and he asked him why. If there's red and green and blue, can't little penguins be colorful too? I want to be blue, just like a whale. A big blue whale with a big blue tail. Pip, you're not big, and you're just not blue. You're black and white, and quite small too. Then I want to be green, like a crocodile. A crocodile with a snappy smile. But penguins are not crocodiles. You're black and white, and you walk for miles. Then can I be red? Just like a fox with a bushy tail and 4 black socks? No, you're not red or sly or cunning. You're black and white and not made for running. Then I want to be orange, like orangutan. Orangutan in a jungle gang. But a penguin can't live high in a tree. You're black and white, and you'd miss the sea. Can I be purple, like a butterfly, and fly with the birds up in the sky? Penguins can't fly to and fro. You're black and white, and you slide on snow. Then I'm going to be pink, just like a pig, with a curly tail and a belly so big. But you're not pink, and you don't like muck. You're black and white with feet like a duck. Can I be brown like a fearsome bear? A grizzly bear with a grizzly stare? Pip, you're black and white with a lovable stare, and about as fierce as a teddy bear. Then I'm going to be yellow, like a big proud lion. A lion that's brave and as strong as iron. But Pip, you're not a yellow cat. You're black and white. And that's that. Look, says Dad, it's skunk and zebra, panda too. They're black and white just like you. What's so wrong with black and white? We think black and white's all right. So at last, little Pip has learned to see that being yourself is the way to be. The end.
Our scripture verse for tonight comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 10 and verse 30. And it tells us that even the very hairs on our head are numbered. Wow. God loves us so much. He paid such close attention to all the little details when He made us. That's really special. I'm glad He loves us that much. Well, we've reached the end of our show and we are all out of time. I'm glad you joined me tonight, and I hope you will join us again next Saturday night. And until then, turn to someone there with you and say, you are worth more than you know, capable of more than you think, and loved more than you can imagine. Good night.